subscriber would like to know, there are those who believe that off-world beings known as greys, or even extraterrestrials in general, are identical to what religious scripture calls jinn or demons. Do you see what the public refers to as aliens having an affiliation with the lower astral or demonic world, or are they distinct and different beings?
Completely different and distinct beings. Most demons, you would say, do not have a physical body as such. They tend to operate in the astral. They can affect physical matter, but they generally don't take a physical body because it's limiting. Aliens, however, and there are many different kinds, races, species, as you can imagine, while they have different densities, they do tend to have a physical body. So some of them who are more advanced can decide to stay alive as long as they like, or to relinquish their body and start over or go somewhere else. Oftentimes, they will relinquish their body and have an experience elsewhere, push their way into flesh somewhere else as a soul, live that life, and then leave. They can come and go as they please this way. The ones who come to Earth, of course, tend to have amnesia, as this is part of the experience here, and is quite annoying for those of us who wish to understand who we are, the lessons we have to learn, so that we can move on. But it's just part of the package deal of being here on this planet. There are ways to pierce the veil and have this understanding and learn these lessons, but they must be sought out with a certain amount of effort and vigilance and followed through. And in this particular planet, that's quite a bit of energy and effort to put into learning about these past lives yourselves and healing from them, you see. So a bit of a stumbling block here on Earth, but we've chosen to come here and here we are. But as for those entities that were to be considered demonic or negative, as a general rule, they do not take physical bodies. There are a handful that are very negative that have physical bodies, and they would be considered demonic. And to explain this, there, for some, use a measuring system of what is considered demonic, and those that receive a certain rating on the scale will simply be considered demonic because they are so negative. And others who are less negative, mostly these entities that are not in the physical, but some that do have physical bodies, humans, can be measured to see what their level is, their level of integrity. When they start measuring too low, that's when they enter the demonic sphere and would be considered as such, you see. Continue.
Okay, so some UFO abductees report an abduction experience, abruptly halting when they pray to God Almighty or Jesus Christ for help or to intervene to stop the abduction. Briefly, why is this the case?
Because they have dominion over all of creation, you see. There have been times when this one here has been doing readings, and an alien has spotted us, walked down the hallway, peeked around the corner, and when they were seen, assistance was requested, and an angel simply took their wing and swatted them away and said, no, go away. And they obeyed, because they are part of the dominion. They are part of creation, you see. They may be able to see more than we see, but they are still subject to the laws of heaven. And so prayers are very effective with them, as are other methods of protecting yourself from aliens, including the use of magnets around window seals. They do follow the laws of physics and mathematics as well. They are not exempt from them. Continue.
Thank you. Briefly, do you see any deceit going on with lower astral entities, what are commonly referred to as demons or jinn, masquerading as aliens?
It's not so common, but they would consider it a good idea if that's how they can get better access. It's not uncommon for something that is a low-level entity to put on a pretty face or a face that is interesting to humans or to whoever their target is, and then the human is fooled and becomes interested and allows them easier access until the mask slips, of course. But most humans don't see well enough into the astral to see, to understand what they are seeing. And even those who see well can be tricked even temporarily. So there have been times that I here have seen an entity and I look at it carefully and I ask a few questions and the mask slips. And then you see the red eyes or you see the true form and it is something truly low or horrible. And then you know, of course, they try to replace the mask as quickly as they can, but it's too late. So, but that doesn't mean that just for a moment there wasn't a question or two of who are you, where do you come from, which can allow enough access in some cases and can be dangerous. It is not recommended to engage in spirit or spiritual talk outside of the expert level, you see. And even they, we can have a hard time.
Thank you. If an abductee or any other experiencer or what appears to be extraterrestrial phenomena feels or observes an alien experience occurring, can you give any way to tell the difference between an off-world alien being and a mischievous lower astral entity? Any way to tell the difference between the two in the early stages of a visitation?
I wouldn't engage them at all, actually. I would call upon the Archangel Michael for protection to keep me safe and to keep them away. And I would ask that they be revealed through his protection and his power. What am I dealing with? I want to know what I'm dealing with. Not as a matter of curiosity, because curiosity always draws things closer to you, but as a way of protecting yourself. But I would call for assistance, and I would always call the Archangel Michael, because either way, it's a violation of your free will and of your safety. And so neither one should be allowed. But of course, the leaders of this planet have made agreements with these extraterrestrial entities and have bargained with them. So they have permission to be here, even though it is not our permission. They have permission of the governing bodies to be here, to do what they want to do. There are some limitations to this, of course, but for the most part, they are free to do what they will in exchange for technology and other things. You see, continue.
Thank you. That is all. Would you like me to reread the closing statements of a reading?
One moment. There's more to say. So for those, and there are questions in some of the listeners here who want to know about how to protect themselves from aliens, some of this is similar to the prayer of protection and also has to do with sealing the doors and windows of the home energetically by drawing with the finger a pyramid between the top of the windowsill down to the lower left corner, to the right corner, and back up to the middle in a pyramid of protection. As the pyramid is one of the strongest protection symbols available to us, draw it in a symbol of a pyramid of white light, and then at the top of the pyramid put a small magnet, and on the left corner and the right corner put a small magnet. Do this with all the windows in the home. You can do this with the door as well to seal the home from intruders. Also, if the home has any portals or vortexes in it, these can be used as entryways for the extraterrestrials. Also, mirrors, the same thing. And so the mirrors can be sealed the same way as the doors and the windows with the pyramid of light as well as the magnets. And the problem will go away almost instantly, you see. The magnetic interference interferes with their vehicles, interferes with their transportation, interferes with how they operate, as well as the pyramid of protection, which asks them or tells them that they're not permitted here, sort of a do not trespass, and they don't have the authority to enter here. Seal it all in the white light of love and ask for the Archangel Michael's protection for your home, and it is so. Continue.